Hello everyone, I welcome you all in my YouTube channel. This is Lata Awwad, Assistant Professor in the Department of Chemistry at KVN Naik Arts, Commerce and Science College, Canada Corner, Nasik. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the carbon-hydrogen bond formation reaction by using TBTH, that is one of the best name reaction, Barton-McCombie deoxygenation and decarboxylation reaction. Before we proceed, let us revise what we learned in last lecture. So in last lecture we discuss about the radical in synthesis, intermolecular bond formation via tin hydride, that is formation of carbon hydrogen bond by using TBTH, in which we saw the dehalogenation reaction, its general reaction and mechanism involved in it. Later we saw the formation of carbon-carbon bond by using TBTH by taking one example and mechanism of this reaction. Next we saw the cyclization of reaction mechanism, that is cyclic pathway of radical reaction mechanism. Later we saw the selectivity of radical reactivity, in which we saw the nitrile radical, tin radical, R radical and its selectivity and reactivity. How radical reacts like or how radical does not react. Then next we saw the requirements for the successful use of thin radical. We also saw the pattern of polar reaction and free radical reaction, how polar reaction react and how radical reaction are react. And lastly we saw the typical reactivity pattern of polar nucleophilic nucleophile and radical with different compounds, that is alpha beta unsaturated compounds, alkyl halides and normal carbon hydrogen or carbon oxygen bonds. Now we will see the Barton-McCombie deoxygenation reaction, the reaction in which hydroxy functional group in an organic compound is replaced by hydrogen to give alkyl group, called as Barton-McCombie deoxygenation reaction. So see the general reaction. If this alcohol is treated with first NaH, second carbon thioxide, carbon dithioxide, third is alkyl iodide, we get this xanthate ester. This xanthate ester is treated with TBTH in presence of AIBN and light, we get this alkyl group as a product, that is OH group is replaced by hydrogen, where R is any alkyl group and R1 is hydrogen methyl डायऑक्सी, मिथॉक्सी, पीएच, ओपीएच एंड इमिडाज़ोल। Let us see the mechanism of this reaction. In first step, sodium hydride abstract this hydrogen and formation of alkoxide ion take place. In next step, this alkoxide ion attack on this carbon and we get this moiety. In next step, this moiety is treated with given alkyl iodide. So this negative charge attack on this R1 group and I kick out and we get this xanthate ester. The next step of mechanism is radical mechanism. So AIBN in presence of light we get this nitrile radical. If this radical is treated with tin hydride, we get plus tin radical. In next step, this tin radical is reacts with this double bond and there is formation of new radical and we get here new radical this moiety. In next step, this radical and this radical reacts with each other and formation of double bond and here new formation of new radical. We get plus R radical. So in the next step, these R radical abstract hydrogen radical from TBTH and we get our desired product. Consider one problem based on this reaction. if this moiety is treated with NH carbon dioxide and methyl iodide, and nextly AIBN and TBTH, we get this as a product. Let us see mechanism of this reaction. So in first step, the base abstract this hydrogen and formation of negative charge take place on the oxygen atom. And we get this. In next step, this negative charge attack on this carbon and these bond open on oxygen, and we get this moiety. Here sulfur carries negative charge. In next step, this moiety is treated with methyl iodide. This negative charge attack on this methyl group and iodide kick out, and we get next step of mechanism is free radical mechanism. When TBTH is treated with AIBN, we get TBTH radical. So this TBTH radical is reacts with this double bond, there is formation of new radical take place, and we get oxygen, carbon bond, sulfur, and here new radical, here sulfur and Me. So in the next step, these radical combine and here formation of new radical take place and we get here new radical in next step these radical abstract hydrogen radical from the TBTH and we get our given product. Now we will see the decarboxylation reaction. So consider this sodium salt of N hydroxy pyridine to thion. This N hydroxy pyridine to thion is reacts with acyl halide. We get this as a product. When this is treated with AIBN and TBTH, we get alkyl group as a product. So let us see the mechanism of this reaction. In first step, this sodium salt of N hydroxy pyridine 2 thion is reacts with acyl chloride and we get this as a product. In next step, when AIBN or TBTH in presence of light we get two molecules of nitrile radical which abstract hydrogen radical from TBTH and formation of TBTH radical take place. This TBTH radical reacts with this double bond and there is a formation of new radical and we get sulfur. Here new form radical. In next step, these bond get cleave, these radical get combined, and there is formation of new carboxylic radical take place. With this side product and our carboxylic radical. These carboxylic radical which on decarboxylation we get R radical. In next step, these R radical abstract hydrogen radical from the TBTH and formation of alkyl group take place. So this is all about Barton-MacCombie deoxygenation reaction and decarboxylation reaction.